Hello, welcome to week three. So this week's video is dedicated to attitude. Now you may have heard the quote that says, where attention goes, energy flows. So that quote basically sums up my entire video. Basically, I want to talk to you about how important attitude is. Attitude is something, believe it or not, that can affect us in everyday situations in the way that we feel about ourselves, the way we feel about our relationships, the way we feel about our work, the way we feel about our body, our health, everything. So I want you to start getting quite clear on what it is that you focus on. What are you bringing into your life? If you constantly look in the mirror and think, I'm not good enough, gotta lose those 5 kilos, or if you're constantly looking at your social media feed and you're thinking, why can't those 200 extra people follow me so I can be like her? Or if you're constantly thinking that you're not worthy of the promotion that you would like, whatever it is, that stuff matters. That stuff really matters. So whatever it is that you focus on, where your attention goes, that is the energy that you're bringing into your life in every single way you can imagine. If you are really focused on, I'm so busy, I'm so stressed, I don't have enough time, oh my goodness, then you're not going to have enough time and you're going to continue to feel stressed. That doesn't help the situation, it just fuels it. So it's really important to start getting conscious as to where is your energy going, where is your attention going, and what is your attitude saying about your overall belief about your life. So Matthew McConaughey said in, I think, this year's Oscar-winning acceptance speech that gratitude has completely changed his life. And it's changed mine too. If you're in a situation where you feel really icky about something, you know, if you're, you know, the way, you know, the way your body looks, or the way a relationship is going, friendship or otherwise, if you focus on that too much, sooner or later, the other areas of your life will be affected. And by that, I mean, you know, the physical side of your life, you know, the way your body looks and feels, your health, you know, how you feel and perform at work, the sort of friend that you are, the sort of partner you are, the sort of daughter, son, whatever you are. So start getting quite clear as to what sort of attitude you have in your life. Am I a positive person or am I quite negative? If the answer is that you can be quite negative, that is completely fine. Everybody gets in a little funk here or there. The thing that's really important to remember is that if you're in a situation that's not making you feel great, you have the power to change that. And I'm not saying that by thinking differently, you're gonna snap your fingers and be able to get yourself out of the situation. But if you're looking in the mirror and all of a sudden you're feeling, oh, why do I look like that? Everyone has those moments, it's so okay. Instead of putting pressure on yourself to feel better about it in an instant, just shift your focus. If you're looking in a mirror and you don't feel great, then shift your focus to something you do feel great about. Be really grateful for the boyfriend you have, or be really grateful for how supportive your best friend is, or be so happy that you have the job that you do. There is always something to be grateful for. So I suppose something that I want you to start doing is to start being really conscious as to what attitude you have. And in moments where you don't feel great about something, or you think quite negatively about something, I want you to flip it, and I want you to get your attention off the negative and onto a positive that might not be related at all. The negative might be in one direction and the positive can be in something not even related to, you know, whatever you're upset about. Attitude is so important, and so is gratitude. So Matthew McConaughey said in his speech that gratitude has completely changed everything, because the more that you are grateful, the more you have to be grateful for. So I really want you to start doing something that's so basic, and that is simply to start listing things off each day that you're grateful for. Write a list. It can be 5 things, 3 things, 2 things, whatever's easiest for you to start with now. Just remember, in times where you don't feel great about something, that every single person on this earth has insecurities and has weaknesses, and we all go through times where we wish that things weren't as they are. I might wish that I had this many more followers on my blog, or I might wish that, gosh, I don't know, I was more flexible in yoga, you know, because the girl next to me can do a handstand and I can't. We are so silly about comparing and about negativity and about attitude. But attitude can and will transform your life. So I'm absolutely certain that it can work for you as well. But what you have to do that might be different to other things is you have to commit. Your attitude will not change if you just kind of cruise along as you've always been going. If you want to have a more positive outlook on life and if you want to feel better, you have to commit to it. So for the next, say, week until I check in with you again, I want you to commit to finding 5 things you're grateful about every day. And it doesn't have to be related to something you're feeling yucky about. Forget about that. Move on to something else. You don't have to worry about trying to feel better about that if it's really hard. So a couple things for you to take away from this. One is to get really clear on your attitude. Just witness it. Am I a positive person or am I a negative person? And you know what? I didn't actually realize that I was being negative in some areas of my life, but I was when I checked in with myself. So I've made a commitment to start being grateful. Start turning the coin a little bit. Start flipping the coin. If I'm being negative, flip it to a positive comment. There is no time or space in life for negativity, because as soon as we're negative, we bring every other aspect of our lives with it and we affect other people. Believe it or not, you affect other people very much in how you come into contact with them in a happy state or in a negative state. So I want you to really witness your attitude towards things, and I want you to really commit to being grateful. Again, 3 to 5 things every single day, and I guarantee you if you do that long enough, your life will transform and more beautiful things will start to come into your life. And then things that you're not so great on, or the things that you're a little bit tied up about and kind of don't feel great, they'll kind of dissolve, because you won't be wasting energy on that, because you'll be focusing too much energy on the things you do feel great about. It works all the time. I constantly am committing to gratitude practices, you know, because sometimes I fall off the wagon and then life kind of, you know, gets on top of me, and then I can commit to my gratitude practice and everything changes. So that is your homework if you choose to accept it. I would love to know your insights in the comments below. I would actually love you to leave 3 or 5 things that you're grateful for in the comments below if you want to start that now. And let's start a positive circle. Imagine if 3, 4, 5 of you write in the comments below 3 to 5 things that you're grateful about. That's a lot of things already there that's really beautiful in life. So I hope you have a beautiful week, and I look forward to talking to you next week. Bye.